Hey there, it's Lynda Cromar coming to you from Colorado. It's been a little while since I've done something that's more about politics. And with the title, The Good, The Bad, The Ugly, I don't know whether you remember that old movie, Clint Eastwood movie, and I don't remember a lot about it, but there was a lot of bad guys. And it seems like that's kind of what's going on in this political contest. Now, one thing I have always been taught as a network marketer, because that is my main actual reason for being on the internet, is that I am a very strong network marketer. So because of that, I feel like it's important to be real about who you are. Now, a lot of people have told me that they believe that you need to actually completely steer clear of talking about what you believe in. The problem with that is that I think it's really hard not to give your opinions. Now, on the other hand, what really is bad is when you start name-calling. So, in this particular political contest, that has been a big thing that has gone on, is a lot of name-calling. What I think goes on and needs to be addressed is that we need to actually be honest about who we are without actually pointing any fingers at anybody else. Whatever somebody else believes has to do with where they are in their life. Maybe they haven't had as much personal development. Maybe they haven't had as much knowledge. Maybe they haven't realized yet that the TV doesn't give them the real truth anymore. And it's up to us actually to actually help them to become to a place of better education. Without putting people down, I don't think that that ever achieves anything. Calling people stupid because they don't agree with you, or calling people not a Christian because they don't agree with you, is not helpful. It does not change minds. It does not help people to have a better attitude, or it does not help people to actually go and seek the truth themselves. If you want people to actually understand, you have to start from where they are instead of where you are. And when you do it that way, it's not going to be insulting, and it's not going to make someone feel less because you might know more. If you give them the opportunity to understand where you're coming from without them feeling less because they don't come from the same place, then you're helping them. So the good is that you offer them your opinion. The bad is that we don't want it to become a fight. We don't want to be any further split with races, creed, or color. Those things don't need to have a reason to divide us. I have seen, and I have to say it, for the most part, an awful lot of race division on the Democratic side and a small amount on the Republican side. I, for one, actually am not a Republican or a Democrat. I'm an independent. Now, I registered as a Democrat when I wanted to go in caucus. But that isn't actually what I call myself. And the reason why behind that is because I always like to look at the candidate. I like to take the time to find out what they're about. I like to see what they actually represent. And what better way to find out than to actually go and watch on YouTube a full rally speech? I have a hard time listening to Hillary. Not because of her very screechy voice, which she does have, and often kind of a demeaning and condescending tone, which I find very insulting. And it's pretty easy to tell if you actually listen to how she talks to people. There is more than enough evidence right now for me to realize that she's not going to be a good president for our United States. I would absolutely love to see a woman president someday, but I'd like to see one with integrity, actually with values, maybe even Christian, become one of our presidents, and if that's at all possible. But I do know that we're at a very important crossroads right now. I am not a serious Trump, I guess what you can say is I'm not a groupie. I am not involved in believing that he is the right one because of so much of the stuff that people say and do. I do look at the whole person, and one of the things that actually very much attracted me to believe that he could do what he says is based on the kind of children he raised. And you can go and say, yeah, a nanny raised him, but I happen to know that isn't the truth. I know that he actually had a very active part in their raising because they all say so themselves. And because of the adults they became. That is a pretty good indication. I feel pretty good about my children, but I know that I had to be a hands-on parent. And I was a divorced mother. My first marriage did not last. We had a very bad relationship. It was abusive. And I could see that it was not going to help in the long run for my children to have a good upbringing and a good adulthood if I stayed in that marriage. I could have out of fear, because I didn't actually have a plan on how I was going to raise my kids and take care of their needs. But I left that marriage because I realized it was harmful, not just to me, but to my children. And I believe that's what we need to do in this country right now. We need to leave the status quo. We need to leave the establishment of politicians. And we need to do what happened in 1980. You may not know this. I don't know how old you are. But if you go back to history, Carter and Reagan. Carter had been a very disastrous president. He put us in double-digit inflation. We had a lot of serious things going on. A lot of wars, a lot of rumors of wars, a lot of taxes, a lot of really tough stuff going on that really hurt us. Reagan cut our taxes down, and by doing that, we actually came in to a very prosperous time. And it was because you may think cutting taxes actually hurts you, but it actually helps, because what it does is it makes people feel more confident to spend. And it also makes people more confident to start new enterprises. And that is precisely what we need right now. We need a better place for our country to be. Having more taxes just destroys the ability of our country to grow. And it definitely will not increase our situation with businesses. Now, we're in a very precarious place war-wise, too. Russia and Syria are in a red state, meaning that we are at the very edge of a very serious war. And it will not be a simple little war with a few bombs being dropped over in Syria. It will be a whole lot worse. It could even mean that we see bombs hitting our own soil. We do not want that. We want somebody that will actually sit down with Putin and hammer out an agreement that allows us to both save face and to actually eliminate ISIS. ISIS is the threat. And the politicians that want war is actually a threat to all of us and to the way we want to live. So that is why I believe Trump is the best solution. Is he the perfect candidate? Well, since when did we have a perfect candidate? Let's be real. And did we ever have anybody that could be considered a saint? No. That probably is not going to happen. And I hear a lot of my Christian friends say, well, Jesus is the king. Well, yes, he is. But he's not the king of the United States, and that's never going to happen. But I can tell you one thing, that's what Hillary Clinton wants. She wants really to be the queen. She wants that one world government that will actually destroy the last of what America really is. So that slogan of Make America Great, it's not racist. It's talking about exceptionalism for America again. And we absolutely do need that. And we are on a very bad road. Now let's actually look also at what's going on with our deficit. Increasing government constantly in every single presidency, and especially in the time of Obama's reign, has caused an inflation and a growth of 1.1, which actually is probably less than that. That means there's absolutely no growth, and we have a deficit going on that cannot continue without us completely falling as a nation. Well, all we have to do is look back at other nations that have had the same kind of thing and know that's what's going to happen here. We're not above it, and we are definitely in a very, very serious place. And the last thing I want to say is we have to stop letting other people make our decisions for us. I made a post about that on my Facebook profile earlier today, that it's important for us to make our own decisions based on our own knowledge, not on what we see on TV, because I can promise you, you're not getting the truth there. So don't just take my word for it. Go and research for yourself. And also, on this page, I take the time to share a lot of things that can be helpful to you. And I really admonish you to go and find out for yourself. Go watch real talks from Trump. There are channels that do no talking over him, but actually share the entire thing that he said. And absolutely, the last 3 weeks in particular have been fantastic. He has not deviated from explaining exactly what he's going to do as president of our new nation. And we do need a renewing of this nation. We need to preserve the Constitution. We need to stop going in the direction we're going. If we let it happen, we will stop being the United States. And we will just be part of a big conglomerate called the Pacific Agreement, which really is a nice way of saying we will become part of a world government, which will control us from afar, and we will have no say. So if you want to be slaves to that, go ahead, ignore it. But you had a chance to have somebody that was a Christian in Mitt Romney, and you chose not to elect that man. So now we have maybe a less perfect man, but one that says he will do it, and I believe he will. You know why? Because when he says he's going to do something, he usually does. If you can look at his track record, look at everything that he built. He comes in under budget and under the time allotted. Isn't that what we want for our United States once and for all? Don't we want to get rid of the corruption? Don't we want to get rid of the overspending? Don't we want to get down under the budget and actually balance a budget for the first time in many, many years, if we ever did at all? It's time. It's really time to make our America great again. And the only way that's going to happen, it's not going to be just one man that does it. It's going to be all of us. So let's all stand behind this man and let him do the job he promised to do. And let us fight against corruption, because if we do not, we will be just as bad as the ones that are corrupt. That's what I have to share with you today, and I hope you share this video far and wide, because people need to really understand what we're up against. Bye for now.